When you look at the case of Uganda, in 2020, we scored 27. We maintained the same in 2021. In 2022, we declined by one, went to 26. And in 2023, we have maintained the same score of 2026. So we haven't improved and we haven't declined.
Uganda's score on the Corruption Perceptions Index for about 5 years has stuck between 27 and 26. This year's CPI was conducted and released under the theme, Weakening Justice Systems Leave Corruption Unchecked. The organization has since dropped rankings to scores in its Corruption Perception Index reports. It relies on 13 independent data sources and uses a scale of 0 to 100, where 0 is highly corrupt and 100 is very clean.
With 11%, squad 11, followed by Venezuela, followed by Syria. Venezuela has 13, Syria has 13, South Sudan has 13, and Yemen has 16. This take the bottom spots in the index. This is the CPI index. They are all affected by protracted crises, mostly armed conflict.
The Inspector General of Government, Betty Kamya, recently revealed that Uganda loses at least 9.1 trillion shillings a year in corruption. At almost every forum President Yoweri Museveni has addressed, he has regretted that corruption was holding back the rapid progress of the country. The president has since backed the efforts of the IGG with State House supervised anti-corruption entities such as the State House Anti-Corruption Unit. The Colonel Edith Nakalema led State House Investors Protection Unit, State House Health Monitoring Unit, among others, to strengthen the fight against corruption. Somalia, which has since joined the East African Community, not only scores the least in the region, but also globally at 11. 180 countries were evaluated and accordingly scored. Denmark, for the sixth consecutive year, topped the index with a score of 90, with Finland and New Zealand following closely with scores of 87 and 85 respectively. The countries go on to lead in the rule of law index attributed to well-functioning justice systems. Lilian Zawede Senteza, the program coordinator at Transparency International Uganda, highlighted that shielding the justice system from interference is paramount for its functioning.
Introducing integrity and monitoring mechanisms. Ensuring that the special protections required by members of the justice system to perform their functions are not abused. Abuse may be prevented through dedicated whistleblowing and reporting channels, as well as requirements for judges, prosecutors, and other relevant actors to disclose their assets and interests.
Report by Sharon Navasirie for the news.